Hello children, I hope you all have learned the first chapter and completed your homeworks and notes. Today we will start our second chapter, Components of Food. Our topics includes: what do different food items contain? What do various nutrients do for our body? And activities, that is, test for carbohydrates, test for protein, and test for fats. Components of food. We know that food contains nutrients. What are nutrients? Nutrients are substances that are needed by our body for healthy growth and functioning. What are nutrients? They are some kind of substances. Okay? They are some kind of substances which our body needs for proper growth and functioning. Understood? They are some kind of substances which our body needs for healthy growth and functioning. Okay? Then food contains nutrients or components, that we know. Okay? The food that we eat contains of different nutrients or components. They are of five main components of our food. First one is carbohydrates. Second, fats. Third, proteins. Fifth, vitamins. Then, minerals. These are the five main components. Which are they? Carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. Along with this, we also require dietary fiber and water. Okay, along this main components, our body also need fiber and water. These components together keep the body healthy. All these components, that is carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, and fiber and water, keep our body healthy. Let us learn about each of them in detail in the coming slides. We shall start with carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are important to our body. They provide us the energy needed to work through the day. Starch and sugar are the two main types of carbohydrates that are found in food. Sugar, first one, sugar. Table sugar, fruits, and honey are some source of sugar. Milk contains a type of sugar called lactose. Okay, so there are two types of carbohydrates. One is sugar and second one is starch. Sugar and starch are the two types of carbohydrates found in food. And examples of sugar are table sugar, fruits, and honey. And milk contains a sugar called lactose. Next is starch. Green plants make their own food in the form of sugar, some of which is converted and stored as starch in the plants. Rice, wheat, corn, potatoes, and bread are some of the sources of starch. When we eat starch-containing plant products, our body breaks down the starch into glucose, which can be easily utilized by the body. So, that's about carbohydrates. What are carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are energy-giving food. Carbohydrates provide energy to the body. Okay? Then there are two types of carbohydrates present in the food. That is, first one is sugar. Examples of sugars are table sugar, fruits, and honey. And second, starch. Examples of starch are rice, wheat, corn, potatoes, and bread. Next is fats. Fats keep our bodies warm and also provide us energy. Fats are of two types. First one, those which are mostly solid at room temperature. For example, butter. And those which are mostly liquid at room temperature. That is, for example, vegetable oil. So, fats are of two types. One is solid at room temperature. Example is butter. And liquid at room temperature. Example is vegetable oil. Okay. Oil, ghee, nuts, butter, cream, and cheese are rich source of fats. Fats are also present in milk, fish, meat, and eggs. Fats give us much more energy than carbohydrates. We get more energy from fats than carbohydrates. A limited amount of fats is important in the diet for healthy functioning of the body. We need only less amount of fat. Okay. However, eating too much of fats can be harmful. Excess of fats consumed are stored in cells called the fat cells in the body. Over a period of time, this leads to a condition called obesity and may also cause heart diseases. Junk foods such as sweets, chips, fries, burgers, candies, and soft drinks are harmful because they are poor in their nutrient content but have a high amount of fats and sugars. So, our body needs only less amount of fats. If we take excess amount of fats, what will happen? our body experience some diseases like heart diseases or obesity. Okay? Next is proteins. Our muscles, organs, and even blood is made up of proteins along with other things. Our body needs proteins for muscle building and repairing worn out tissues. If we do not eat the required amount of proteins, our body will not be able to repair damaged cells or build new ones. Rich sources of animal proteins are meat, fish, eggs, and milk. Rich sources of plant proteins are pulses, soya beans, grams, and nuts. Vitamins. Our body needs vitamins and minerals for its normal functioning and prevention from diseases. Vitamins help in keeping our eyes, bones, teeth, and gums healthy. Vitamins are of two types. fat-soluble vitamins and water-soluble vitamins. Let us see what is fat-soluble vitamins. Fat-soluble vitamins are vitamins A, D, E and K. These vitamins are stored in the fat tissues of the body and used as and when the body needs them. Okay, these fat soluble vitamins are stored in the fat tissues of the body and it is used whenever a body needs. Then vitamin D is also prepared by our body in the presence of sunlight. Okay, and about water soluble vitamins. Water soluble vitamins are vitamins C and B complex. And this B complex includes a group of vitamin that is B1, B2, B3, B6, B12 and folic acid. Water soluble vitamins cannot be stored in the body and therefore need to be regularly supplied through the food. Understood? What is the difference of fat-soluble vitamins and water-soluble vitamins? Fat-soluble vitamins can be stored in the fat tissues of the body and body can use it whenever the body needs. Okay, but water-soluble vitamins cannot be stored in the body and therefore we need to be regularly supplied through food. That is why your parents are telling eat vegetables, enough vegetables and fruits daily. Okay. Then lack of vitamins in the body affects the functioning of the body organs and causes deficiency diseases. So we need to be eat enough vitamins, that is water soluble vitamins, regularly. Minerals. Minerals help in the proper functioning of the various parts of the body. Minerals are needed for growth and health of our body. Some of the minerals are given here. First one is calcium. It makes bones and teeth strong. Milk. What are the sources of calcium? Milk, cheese, curd, ragi, green leafy vegetables and soya beans are rich in calcium. Iron. The body needs iron to make red blood cells. Sources of iron are green leafy vegetables, whole wheat, pulses, apples, nuts, fish, liver and meat are good sources of iron. Potassium. It helps to keep the muscles, brain and nerves healthy. It also maintains water balance in the body. Tomatoes, green leafy vegetables, dates, jaggery, beans, fruits and fish are rich in potassium. Last one is iodine. It is needed for the proper growth of the body. It can be obtained from fish, shellfish, edible marine algae, vegetables and fruits grown in the coastal regions as well as from iodized salt. Okay, so these are the four minerals given here. Okay, first is calcium, iron, potassium and iodine. Next is about fiber. Have you noticed that when you eat an orange, apart from the juice, you also consume the fiber of the fruit? How is this fiber helpful to us? Is fiber present in other food too? Yes, we know that fiber is present in the other food too, right? The fiber present in our food is called dietary fiber. It is a very important part of our diet. dietary fiber as bulk to our food and thus help to push solid waste through the intestine so that they can be easily passed out of the body. What? This dietary fiber helps to push solid waste, to push our solid waste through the intestines so that they can be easily passed out of the body. We get fiber mostly from plant food, that is from fruits, vegetables and whole grains are examples of food rich in fiber. Lack of fiber in the diet causes the stool to become hard and difficult to pass, leading to a condition called constipation. Therefore, we must ensure that our diet is rich in dietary fiber. Like other components, this fiber is also an important component for our body. Next is water. We know that our body is mostly made of water. Almost 70% of our body weight is water. Water is needed by our body for the following function: to transport various substances within the body, to help the body absorb nutrients from food, to control the body temperature, to allow various chemical reactions to take place inside our body during digestion, respiration, excretion, etc. We lose a lot of water as sweat and urine. We need to drink enough water, otherwise it can lead to a condition called dehydration. We also get water from milk, fruits, vegetables and juices. However, we should try and drink at least 8 to 10 glasses of water every day to keep us hydrated. So, let us say once more. Water is needed for the proper functioning of the body. It is a major component of the blood and every cell. It maintains body temperature. It helps in digestion. It helps in cleaning blood by forming urine. These are the main functions of the water. So we have discussed about the main components of food. Now let us do some activities, that is test for starch, test for fats and test for proteins. That is the test to test the presence of starch, fats and proteins in the food. We shall begin with starch. Take a teaspoon of cooked or raw food. We have to take carbohydrates food. For example, we can take cooked rice. Rice is a carbohydrate food. So we can take cooked rice. If the food item contains, if the food item is a solid, grind it into a powder or paste. We can convert it into that food into powder or paste. Add 2 to 3 drops of dilute iodine solution to the food item. And after making it a powder or paste, add 2 or 3 drops of dilute iodine solution to the food. Okay, then if the food item contains starch, it forms a bluish black color. Okay. This iodine solution reacts with starch gives bluish black color. That is the result of the test for starch. Okay, if the food item contains starch, thus iodine solution reacts with starch, gives bluish black color. Now test for fats. What are the fats food, fatty food? Examples are nuts, and most of the nuts are fatty foods. That is cashew nut, badam, almonds, then groundnut. These are the examples of fatty food. Then wrap a few groundnuts in a newspaper and crush them. Okay, crush them means powder, crush it. Take a newspaper and put this groundnuts in on the paper, and after that crush it. Remove the crushed groundnuts from the paper. What we will observe, after 10 minutes or after some time, we can notice that oil patch on the paper. We can notice an oil patch on the paper. This shows that fats are present in that nuts, in that groundnut. Okay, this is the test for starch and test for fats. Here, test for proteins. Take half a teaspoon of boiled dal paste or raw gram flour. You know, most of the pulses are the sources of proteins. So here we took dal paste. Okay. To it, add 4 teaspoons of water and mix it. Take half of the solution in a test tube and 2-3 drops of copper sulfate solution. Okay, half of the water, after taking this dal paste, we add 4 teaspoons of water and we mix it. Okay, then after that, half of the paste or half of the solution, we took it in the in a test tube and add 2-3 drops of copper sulfate solution. Add 10 drops of caustic soda solution to the mixture. Shake well and leave it undisturbed for about 5 minutes. If violet color develops, then the food contains proteins. Okay, if the violet color appears, then we can conclude that the food contains proteins. Test for starch and test for protein, you can't do it in the home. Okay, test for fats, you do it in the home. And in the next slide, you can watch the video of the test for starch, proteins and fats.
Test food for starch. Before we start our experiment to test the presence of starch in food, let us first understand what is starch. Starch is a complex carbohydrate present in the food we eat. Starch is odorless, tasteless, and white in color. What are the major sources of starch? Major sources of starch are rice, corn, wheat, and potatoes. Let us start our experiment to test the presence of starch in food. Take a small quantity of rice in a petri dish. Make a fine paste of the rice using water. Put the paste in a test tube. Add a few drops of iodine solution with the help of a dropper. What do you observe? The sample turns blue-black, which confirms the presence of starch in rice. Note: whenever starch reacts with iodine solution, it turns blue-black. Test food for protein. Before we start our experiment to test food for protein, let us first understand what is protein. Proteins are large molecules consisting of amino acids, which our body and the cells in our body require to function properly. Our body structure functions, regulations of the body cells, tissues, and organs cannot exist without proteins. The muscles, the skin, the bones, and many other parts of the human body contain significant amount of protein. In fact, protein accounts for 20% of the total body weight. What are the major sources of protein? The major sources of vegetable protein are soybean, cereals, beans, and groundnuts. Major sources of animal protein are egg, fish, meat, and milk. Let us start our experiment to test the presence of protein in our food. Take a small quantity of mashed beans in a petri dish. Put it in a test tube and add some water. Add a few drops of copper sulfate solution to it with the help of a dropper. Then add a few drops of sodium hydroxide solution. What do you observe? The sample turns purple, which confirms the presence of protein in the food sample. Note: whenever protein reacts with copper sulfate and sodium hydroxide solution, it turns purple. Test food for fat. Before we start our experiment to test food for fat, let us first understand what is fat. Fat is a nutrient essential for normal function of the body, and living is not possible without it. Not only does fat supply us energy, it also makes it possible for other nutrients to do their jobs. What are the major sources of fat? The major sources of fat obtained from plants are mustard oil, coconut oil, and dry fruits. Major sources of fat obtained from animals are butter, ghee, and cheese. Let us start our experiment to test the presence of fat in food. Take a small quantity of dry fruits, such as cashew nuts or almonds, in a petri dish. Rub it on a clean white paper. You will observe oily patches on the paper. Hold the paper against the light to see the oily and translucent patch clearly. The fat present in the food sample is what makes the paper oily and translucent. test food for sugar. Before we start our experiment to test food for sugar, let us first understand what is sugar. Sugar is the generalized name for sweet carbohydrates, which are soluble in water. They are composed of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. What are the major sources of sugar? Major sources of sugar are fruits, milk, honey, and jaggery. Let us start our experiment to test the presence of sugar in food. Take a small quantity of glucose in a test tube. Add a few drops of Benedict's solution. Heat the test tube in water bath. What do you observe? The sample turns orange, which confirms the presence of sugar in the food sample. Note: whenever sugar reacts with Benedict's solution, it turns orange.
That's all for today. We will continue the same chapter in the next video. Thank you.